We sharpen blades and march with our brethren. To kill the humans is our goal, we gotta win.
Luke Tom.
Russian roulette is not the same without God. But since there are no dwarves around, we'll make do without one.
Bollocks.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. With my red eyes, it's a good day to die. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. With my red eyes, it's a good day to die. Can't beat mine, can't beat mine. No, you will lose to orcish rage. I just wanna kill somebody.
Mission begin. Start off by putting your peon somewhere safe. This one's sticking that orc burrow, but all the rest are on the left side of the map. You want to put on the right side of your map and make them mine gold. This mission is the Hunter of Shadows, but don't ask me what the title refers to because I've got no clue myself. The Night Elves will spend about 4 or 5 minutes destroying your 3 bases on the left side of the map. So you want to start off by building a few defenses at both entrances to your base, and also get a few upgrades in. The objective of this mission is basically the same as Frostborn. You've got to take the long windy path with your hero to go to the objective and then destroy the enemy base. Well, sort of. This is actually probably the only mission in the entire game where one of the main quests isn't necessarily needed to be completed. You don't actually have to go to the fountain and become fell orcs, but there's no way you're going to kill Cenarius without cheating. Unlike in Frostmourne, where you can actually destroy Mal'Ganis' base, but you do still need to get Frostmourne. Get some upgrades at the War Mill and start leveling up your Troll Witch Doctors. Don't bother with the Shamans, because when you become Fel Orcs, they'll be transformed into Chaos Shamans that don't actually need any leveling up. And once he's destroyed 3 of your bases and planted 3 of his bases, Cenarius comes along and completely screws the laws of conservation of energy. So be prepared for a big incoming attack at both entrances. It'll help if you put a few stasis traps around before the attack and make sure your watchtowers that you've built are on higher ground. That means any ground units are likely to miss more often. Try to aim for flyers first because, I mean, Grom can take out any ground units that come across practically by himself. So the flyers are the main target because Grom's got no air attack, has he? Now at the north entrance of the base is another gold mine, so stick a great hole down there and protect it with about 8 to 9 watchtowers. And you'll want to stick a few more watchtowers at the south entrance too. Now you want to head north past your base and either use catapults or peons to get rid of these trees. I thought originally you actually had to farm trees, but you can actually use the attack command with peons or ghouls or peasants and chop down trees that way without collecting them and having to run back to the town hall every time. So with Grom in hand, take him north and you'll fight furbugs, more furbugs with items, and satyrs too, but grab some grunts and spearmen to take the journey with. You might want to build a second barracks too. Then you'll fight a satyr with some skeleton archers, and then just heal up at the healing fountain for the last satyr group. Now you don't actually have to kill everything on the path, but you might as well if you want to have some fun. But if you can't be arsed, then just windwalk Grom all the way up to these satyrs and just blades storm them. When you come across them, they'll say, you know, Grom will say things like, "You're still trying to protect your fountain?" And they'll say, "No, trying to protect you from it." Well, as you know, these guys are actually quite evil, so they won't say that. But in any case, once you've killed them, you'll become fell orcs. Well, while Grom was away, you know, pretty much destroying his entire race, you might have wanted to start building up your army. You know, usual things, 6 grunts, 6 spearmen, a couple of support casters, catapults, and the Kodo Beast plus your hero. Now for some reason, there's a little glitch. When you have Chaos Kodo Beasts, they actually count as, when they're not moving, for some reason they count as peons. You'll always have the indicator that says there's a worker not working, even though it's actually a Kodo Beast. And at your discretion, take your men and just storm the southern base. Once it's destroyed, Cenarius will come along and all you have to do is surround him. Try not to attack him with any spearmen because he'll be, I don't know, not healed, but I don't think their damage actually counts even after you, because, you know, they're not orcs. So Cenarius is basically a keeper of the grove with the ability to do cyclone, and he's also got some, for some reason, less agility, but, and his divine armor can only be hurt by chaos weapons, which is of course what you need the fell orcs for. So once he's dead, that's pretty much the end of the mission. You know, and there aren't really any secrets, so I'm not going to bother putting one in this time, since all the creeps you find are basically on the path to the fountain. I've been your host, Road Jam, saying, you take care of your axes, and they'll take care of you.